Take your enjoyment of Smodco Podcast to the next level by checking out a live Smodco show. Check out J-Muse at Wizard World Comic Con Columbus, Ohio on July 29th. July 29th, Yoga Hosers hits Fantasia Fest in Montreal. Fandom Fest in Louisville hosts Yoga Hosers on July 30th. Can't have a Smodco show without a stop in Red Bank. Yoga Hosers hits the Jersey Shore on August 2nd. Muse visits Terrificon August 19th through 21st in Connecticut. Kevin Smith will be spending his evening in Connecticut August 20th as part of Terrificon. Irvine Improv welcomes Babylon back on Friday, August 26th. J-Muse shares his views at Colorado Springs Comic Con on August 26th. September 2nd, Jay and Bob get old at the Toronto Fan Expo. Denton, Texas proudly hosts Kevin Smith on September 17th. December 11th and 12th, get old with Kevin Smith and Jason Mewes in Colorado. Kev goes solo for a show at South of the Landmark in Colorado on December 11th and 12th. December 13th, Fort Collins brings Kev and Jay to the Lincoln Center. Need something to do in Denver? Check out Jay and Silent Bob Get Old in Larimer Square, December 15th. An evening with Kev graces the stage in Denver, December 15th. JSB come to Telluride, Colorado on December 16th. Kevin won't be skiing in Aspen, but he will definitely be doing a live show December 18th. Tickets to these and all Smodco shows are available now at smodcast.com.
I had a phone call the other day, Q.
Yeah?
touchofmodern.com.
They called you? You called them?
I had to call them, and I had to check in with the phone, like the code and all that shit. And I talked to the Touch of Modern guy and the ad people.
But what is Touch of Modern?
Jesus Christ. Touch of Modern, the perfect gift. Now, this is really sort of male-centric, this site.
Oh, no.
Yeah. It's
that triggers me.
Really directed at this. It even says here, the perfect gift for all the guys in your life. Dad, husbands, brothers, uncles who are notoriously hard to shop for. Now, I'm going to sum it up for you, all right? Just like I did when I was on the phone call, I said to the Touch of Modern guy, I said, so let's just put it out there. This is a bunch of shit that nobody needs.
You said that?
Yes.
Okay.
But a lot of it is very cool and you would want.
Right.
Just like unusual stuff, you know what I mean?
Like a husband or a wife.
Right.
Yeah.
Exactly. Jaw-dropping tech gadgets and gear, homebrewing kits and premium sticks. It has a whole bunch of different stuff. And what their big thing is, like, I guess they go around all over the place looking for cool shit. And then they'll buy it. They put it on the site for a limited amount of time at a pretty steep discount. And then, boom, it's gone.
That sounds pretty cool.
It actually is. I think you have $50 in an account.
Whoa,
I believe so, yeah.
Why come I'm not getting these emails?
I don't know.
They deleted from my box.
Mm-hmm.
Touch of Modern?
Touch of Modern.
I want to buy useless shit.
It is, but there is, like, they have really cool watches. They had a cool basketball I wanted to buy. Mm. Every time you go to the site, it's like being a kid in a candy store.
Mm.
Was that the case? Like, what could be considered, like, Cat's Confectionery, Walt?
There was a candy store above on Snug Harbor, remember?
On Snug Harbor?
Yeah. It was it was candy when I first moved to the Highlands. It was
just candy. That was it.
Yeah, it was just candy.
What a weird place! Like, you couldn't do that today unless you were in like a mall, right?
What, a candy store? There's one right across the street.
Yeah, how well do they do? Well, that's like high end chocolate for fucking fancy pants, though. You know, there's no discount like a Touch of Modern. New sales literally launching every day. Go to touchofmodern.com. Q. You're going to like some of the stuff.
I'm trying to look, but their website, their mobile experience.
Yeah, I think this is a site that was made for guys like you, guys in the fast lane.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
This is the when you don't have time to shop for cool gadgets.
Well, they got cool wallets.
So you go to Touch of Modern, and that's where, like,
all right.
You know.
Oh, they sell beef jerky?
Tactical gear?
Yeah, all right. I can see it. So I have $50 here. Star Wars cufflinks.
Yeah.
I see what you mean. Like, just fun shit. No essentials.
No essentials, just stuff that's kind of fun and unique.
I'm in.
That's touchofmodern.com/TESD, I'm assuming. I don't think it really says here.
They're not tracking it, so.
Right, so they'll never know.
They'll never know.
That we said it's useless shit.
How many units we moved.
Yeah. Right. That doesn't mean you shouldn't go there and check it out, though.
No. Yeah, I would definitely check it out. I mean, there's definitely some.
It's at least one thing you want on there.
Yeah.
Cool. Mm-hmm.
Say fucking Billy Joel's not the best singer again, and you're fucking dead.
fire so I can finger blast you.
I don't want to get him at all. There's certain topics you can't talk about.
Well, now you sound just like his birth parents.
Tell him, Steve Dave.
Hello and welcome to this week's edition of Tell Him, Steve Dave. I am here. Walt is here. And straight off the side of a building in L.A., BQ is here.
Yes.
Did you see that giant memorial to the Impractical Jokers?
Was it San Diego or L.A.?
It's not a memorial.
Oh, your shows didn't get canceled?
Advertised memorial.
I didn't see it. How big was it?
Oh, come on.
Stories?
Dude. 13 stories high.
13 stories high. How do you look 13 stories high?
I mean, it looks fine. It's just that they didn't tell me it was on the side of the hotel we were staying in. So, and I didn't know about it until we pulled up to the hotel, and I was like, oh, fuck, come on, man.
Oh, yeah, you weren't hanging out and just, like, taking pictures, like, just pointing to yourself, like, getting, like, great selfies?
No, I wasn't. It's right next, like, the hotel is right next to the Comedy Store, too, where, like, legends, like, did stand-up. So, like, then I even felt more embarrassed because I was like, oh, God.
Like Dom Herrera's looking at you.
Oh, I know.
I mean, you would have to put in Jokers as modern-day legends.
No,
legends in their own time?
I think you can – you'd have some people definitely place you there. There'd be some resistance.
Anybody
from other
– that.
Yeah.
We could shouldn't have their down. Opinion taken seriously, though.
I mean, you guys are modern-day Marx Brothers.
Yeah. Which one are you? If you're a Marx Brother, which one are you? You're the little dictator.
Not even a modern little day dictator. Alan Funt.
Yeah, didn't Harpo do a movie called Little Dictator?
No, I thought that was Charlie Chaplin.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're right. You're right. So, did the Marx Brothers do any Hitler stuff?
You know, we got a nice little corner of pop culture for ourselves, and I'm happy with that.
Did you pretend you own the hotel to anyone?
No.
No?
I did not.
How was San Diego? Seems like it's a good time, man. Good times had by all. Comic book men fucking sit their asses home year after year.
I don't get how you guys don't go. I just don't get it. Is it because you guys are in production every year when it's been on?
Well, it's a combination of that, and nobody wants us there, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
nobody wants us
there.
We've tried to shoot there.
We've tried to shoot there, and the rules are so weird where they're like, well, we can shut you down at any time. Like, you could be there 1 minute, and suddenly they'll just shut you down. And this is a fire hazard, and that's no good. So to shoot there is nearly impossible. Plus, they have so many A-listers, plus the Jokers. I don't give a fuck about
this. We weren't even allowed inside the con. We had to, like, rent space out of the con.
Oh, really? Then is it like being at the con then? If you have to, like, if you're, like, 10 miles from the con, are you really at the con?
Well, we weren't 10 miles from the con, but
they spent all week convincing themselves they were, and you just fucked it up for them.
I mean, I maybe have to come a little off with that Marx Brothers analogy. Maybe the Bowery Boys is a better analogy. Does anybody get any of these references?
I don't think so.
Anybody listening?
Does that ever concern you when you're
No, I wear that as a badge of fucking honor.
Right?
Yeah, I don't care about all this current pop culture. My pop culture isn't black and white, bitch.
Yeah, there you go. That's a shirt. Print that up, Declan.
I'll accept some Technicolor pop culture.
And the Jokers. That's the only exception. So, we'd like to check in once in a while with Get'em, see how he's doing here at the stash.
Yeah, I walked into a whirlwind of stuff today, huh?
Yeah, it's been going on for a while. Last week, actually, this Monday when we came in, the shelf over there was devoid of pops. And you never heard the word pop said so much in a conversation.
You know what a pop is, Q?
Yeah, it's those figures, those little vinyl figurines.
The world right now is pop mad. They're one of the hottest selling items.
It's been going on for years.
And almost every form of pop culture, if it's popular or if it's even if it's not popular.
Bowery Boys have some, right?
do the Jokers have any pops?
No.
Soon,
nobody wants to hear you yet. Be quiet.
Soon, though, I imagine.
Speak when
it's only a matter of time for the Jokers to get pops.
I don't know. Maybe.
I can't believe that you don't. I mean, in all seriousness, that seems like a no-brainer that you guys would have pops.
Yeah, it is strange that they wouldn't. Not that you care, right? Because you don't get any of the merch.
I doubt I'd get any money from it anyway. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. I guess.
I mean, they got the Golden Girls coming out, I saw.
Well, that's the Golden Girls. They deserve their own to be immortalized in pop
but
figures.
I look
Who's
at
buying them?
That's what I'm saying. I look at it from a retailer's point of view,
yeah.
And I'm like, first off, anybody who's into the Golden Girls is collecting Golden Girls merchandise is got to be in there.
They're spending their funeral money on it.
Yeah, they're not like they're not really usually the target audience for the pop figures. I don't think at the Golden Girls.
Yeah, but I bet you there's a lot of ironic Golden Girls pop purchases.
Oh, I can't stand anybody.
Can't stand
who's
the
ironic.
Irony.
I can't. Yeah. I can't deal with anybody who's ironic.
Here's someone that's not ironic. Get them.
So the pop figures. What were you talking about pop figures for?
Because remember, oh. Like, we came in and Walt's beside himself because he's looking at this pop shelf.
This is the weekend after we did our last live show.
Right.
Last ever or one we did?
Well, possibly both. But I'm off that entire weekend after we did that live show. I don't have to come back to the stash.
Okay.
But get them. Who slayed it at the live show? I thought you would, I mean, you got to give him props when you do.
Course.
He was brilliant.
I wasn't as good as you guys.
That's true.
Don't try to sway us with any kind of brown nosery.
I know. The tongue comes out like once Walt's annoyed. Like, Gidim's bringing him drinks. And, hey, Walt, did you see this? Like trying to pretend reality isn't what it is. Yeah.
So Gidim had to work over the weekend. And the one thing I tell him since day one, I was like, you got to keep up on these pops because the kids will mess up the pops. They think that there's some elusive, hard to find pop figure behind all the pops. So they constantly put them in a disarray. And I want two pop figures out at all times, two of the same ones.
How old do you get them?
38.
Yeah, I'd fucking put a gun in my mouth. That's your life?
Get them!
Yes, sir, boss.
The pops are looking thin. Oh, dude, sweet remember, Jesus. The job before this had a lot of horseshit involved. This is a step up.
Yeah, literal horseshit.
So he knows I'm not going to be around all weekend. He knows it. I'm not going to be around a weekend. Mm-hmm. So you would think that he would at least make sure by Sunday that the pops are in a state of looking good.
Yeah, like before he leaves Sunday night, like, those pops.
No, I was off Sunday.
Popping.
I was off Sunday.
Oh, that's right. You're off.
I only work Saturday.
Okay.
So between Friday and Saturday.
Yeah, that's right. He was trying to put it all on Sunday.
Yeah,
Jeff.
He tried to
like
bring
they
Sunday
sold
Jeff
like
for the
there were literally like I'm not kidding around. Probably 25 different. Pops missing?
Missing from that wall. I would go downstairs and just bring up 10 at a time.
Oh, my God.
And his excuse would always be like, look at the ground, be like, I didn't work Sunday. It must have been Jeff. He must have sold a lot of pops.
And
we didn't sell any that many on Saturday. I told you like the three that I remember selling on Saturday.
Well, it is weird that you would throw Sunday Jeff under the bus. That's very
odd. Dude, another thing that he does that I you got to stop this right
the
now.
The nervous laugh?
No.
I'd light him on fire. Like, as Walt's dressing him down for these pops, he's like, I'm like, what the fuck? Like,
it's not the nervous. I don't mind a nervous laugh. You can keep doing that. But what you got to do is stop making jokes at the expense of your coworkers. You've got to make sure you put the olive branch out. I don't need it. But you know there are some people here that are do not find – when you start taking pokes at other rival – not rival. That would be the proper word.
Sister
inferior.
Inferior.
I mean, he starts poking at I Sell Comics and it does not go over well.
With I guess, Chief.
It's like it looks like the cartoon like when they pull like that work whistle. It's like the steam whistle shooting out.
Yeah. I mean, you could feel the animosity if you made that crack today, right?
Yeah.
Now, do you like that? Do you like that awkwardness?
No, but it just –
But what am I going to take? I'm not going to take a shot. He leaves me wide open. But he puts it up there. I'm not going to hit a home run.
Yeah, I mean, I feel you.
Well, I get so much practice with Rob Bruce because Rob Bruce is nothing to me, really. So I can completely launch into him, and I don't feel worried or anything.
Well, he's not a coworker. You don't have to turn around and be like, I'm here for the next 7 hours with you.
Yeah, but like there are days when you work with Mike just all by yourself, and you really want that kind of relationship?
I think we have a good relationship.
Did you see how pissed he was after you said that?
I've seen him more pissed.
Come back with this. Get him. No one likes you.
Yeah, that's not a jokey kind of like, right? Right? You're disliked?
You got to stop. That's one thing. I'm not even trying to be
okay,
funny. I really would. I would muzzle the jokes at the expense of other podcasters.
Okay, I will.
Okay. And that's just, you know, some work advice.
Okay.
I don't think it's never going to be good for you.
Okay.
It's never going to play out the way you hope. Yeah, whatever you're seeing in your mind, it's the opposite. And then what did he do today? He did something else fucked up, and he started bringing you peace offerings and shit. Like, I was sitting here.
Oh, yeah. We have an alphabetical order of restocking stuff, trade paperbacks. And I found that Deadpool in the Batman after he had just been in the Batman. And all I said was, I was like, hey, how come there's a Deadpool in here? I don't know. I wasn't looking for it. I just put it there. So defensive instead of just being like, oh, I didn't see it. Or, you know what? Let me do it. Let me go put it in. You just were there and you were so defensive and so like wanting to deflect. Never. You're not good at being like, yeah, that's my bad.
Well, but it wasn't my bad.
Because he never fucking admits it. He's horrible at it. He's never done it once.
You're really not good at saying, like, my bad, are you?
I can if it's my fault, but that wasn't my fault.
But you were just in the Batman.
Yeah, because I was looking for Batman.
But how did you not notice that there was a Deadpool in there?
I just didn't see it. I was looking for the specific name Batman and also an orange spine because it was Batman, I think it was Haunted Knight. And it has an orange spine. So that's what I was looking for. I wasn't looking for Deadpool. So I just kind of skipped over it.
So you were telling me unless you're that zoned in that if you're seeing Batman, 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 Deadpool, Batman, Batman, you're not going to see it?
I did not see it in there. That's the truth.
I mean, well, I'm sorry. I think that you've got to make sure you do see it though.
Okay.
I love it.
I mean, really? I mean, yeah. Right? I mean, am I wrong? I mean, you got to see it.
No, I mean, you're right. His response should be like, oh, wow, I didn't see that blows in there. All right, I'll just make sure it's not like that.
Don't blame somebody else for putting it there.
You know, the fault lies in those weak enough to lay blame, Walt. I read that in a fortune cookie once. You know?
So it's my fault?
No, he's laying
blame. Oh, okay.
You're managing. You're doing.
You're always right.
I'm trying.
You're trying to guide him.
I'm trying to. I'm trying to put into his head everything that I know so he, you know, he has all the tools necessary.
Well, the conversation right before you got here is he's going to get him an intern. Get him can't handle it.
How the fuck did that come to?
Yeah, why did you need an intern?
No. Because I couldn't find I didn't see the Deadpool comic was the reason I needed an intern.
And then he comes over, and I understand how Walt falls prey to it. Gidim comes over, and we're talking about something, and out of nowhere, Gidim's like, hey, did you know that postal vehicles have the right-of-way over ambulances, cops, fire trucks, everybody? And we're like, really? And like for a second, you just buy it, and you're ready to move on and like maybe even tell someone else later on. But then I was like, that doesn't sound right. And I look it up, and it's like he's full of shit.
But even Mike was like, yeah. He goes, that's true. It used to be an old question.
So what?
I know. Just because you guys are sucking each other's dicks doesn't mean it's fucking – the facts are correct. He's just sucking up to you. He doesn't want you to make fun of him anymore. Come on. Get him. Let's make fun of Walt.
Yeah, you know, if you feel that you like you guys can you can slag on me, I don't care. But there's some people you shouldn't slag on, no.
One third of your coworkers. That's pretty great. All right, get the fuck out of here. Okay. People don't watch you here. Nobody likes you.
Wait, are we gonna talk about this fucking thing?
Oh yeah, what about that?
Oh yeah.
Hey, you're a member of the Loot Crate,
member of the Loot Crate community, yes.
Yeah, well,
yes.
I'm also a member and I get to work today and get him's all like in a hussy, you know, he's all like winded and he's like, did you get your Loot Crate this month? There's a Futurama item in there that I'd like to buy off you if you do.
Wow.
And I told him, I was just like, and I gave him a price.
What was your price?
$20.
$20.
And he said no, but he said he really wants it though.
But I said we could sell it for more money on eBay than I could give you.
Yeah, but I said I didn't care.
So well, I do. Trying to make money for the store.
What, this is selling on eBay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
For how much?
$25.
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Well, so Walt, he didn't want the deal? He was like, we could sell it for $5 more?
Yeah, I told him I didn't care. I told him that if he wants it, he can have it. But then I saw when Q walked in with one. I don't know why you were bringing it down here today, but his eyes were – like he didn't even look at you walking through the door. His eyes went to the box, and he was – it looked like, you know, a dog that just saw a T-bone. He couldn't take his eyes off it.
I mean, there's hundreds of them on eBay.
Yeah.
Hundreds. Okay. Well, my thing is, like, every once in a while, I've brought stuff down before. I was like, ah, just sell it in the store, and then one day if I want a comic, I'll just, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, it'll all even out in the end and stuff like that. But then I was like, oh, maybe we could do it as one of Ginnam's Teeth. Like, I'll sign it, and we can put it up.
Is it tough now to still try to raise money for Ginnam's Teeth now, and he's working, he's got a regular paycheck?
Does he have medical?
Do you?
Eventually, I believe.
Stop tapping that wire.
So not yet.
Not yet, but he's soon to get it, I would imagine.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't think
he... Is he still in probation?
No, I think you have to... I don't think you can get right into the... I think you have to put in some...
Right.
You just don't get it automatically. You have to have a certain amount of hours in before you're eligible. But he's going to get it eventually. Mm. Is there a need now to...
Well, he had a job when we started it.
Right, but not one that he worked like 3 days... In the wintertime, right?
Yeah.
Well, the medical also won't cover dental, right?
Yeah, and if it – like for major, it's usually 50%.
It's not going to cover a bridge implants anyway.
Yeah, that's – what do they call that?
Cosmetic.
Cosmetic, yeah. Yeah.
So I
– cosmetic surgery, get them?
Make my smile purdy.
Yeah.
I think he'd lose a lot of his charm though because I love it when he comes in and he's got the teeth out.
Yeah, but I don't know if he should –
Yeah, you're basically not here for Walt's amusement. Like, not to be viewed as a human being by the population. Well,
it's so endearing.
Even though. The crew said, what was that, Friday when I just didn't get a chance to put them in?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They love it, right? The crew, like, yeah. It's like a little special gift, you know, on a Friday. Like, get them.
Play the wash tub. Take your teeth out.
Throw on this jug.
You know, it's something they look forward to at the end of the week when Get'em doesn't wear his teeth on Fridays.
Every Friday? Like, they wear superhero shirts and Get'em doesn't, like, he leaves his teeth at home.
Oh. Your version of casual. Your version of casual differs from mine.
Like, how long before they're like, all right, Get'em enough. It's gross.
Well, I mean, I had two ideas. One, I would leave it to Get'em. I would say we could either just sell it. I'll sign it. We could sell it.
Right.
And he'd get the money for his teeth.
But he wants this thing for some reason. Why do you want that?
I like the show. Futurama's a good show.
It's a great show.
What are you going to do with it?
I just put it on display.
Do you take pictures of your house and show people?
No,
yes,
not really.
He does.
Some parts of my house, yes.
Really, there's topics that he's not allowed to talk about.
What do you mean?
Yeah, he's been censored.
Oh, come on, Q. You must have been not IJ, but I imagine at the firehouse there was some rules, topics that you guys couldn't engage in at the firehouse.
Not
right?
At the firehouse.
No,
not
at all.
Bullshit. You could talk about anything you guys wanted.
Sure.
Can you
talk about politics? It's not even like it's something fucking out there. He's like, no politics, get him. Because get him starts getting people mad. Anything.
Sure.
You guys have carte blanche to talk whatever you guys wanted about. Even the most heinous of subjects, you guys could just bring it up.
The more heinous, the better, usually.
Yeah. There's a gallows humor, right?
A real.
I thought there was like, well, isn't there, isn't it? You know, you could talk about how, no matter how gross or how like base a topic.
Sure.
Really? I would thought that there'd be
Well, what
like
are some
rules.
Of the ones that, that Get'em can't talk about?
Yeah, laws are in place.
Oh, well, I was paying attention to laws. I mean, if there was a female firefighter in the house, then everybody might clamp down, but we didn't have any such issues.
Well, now that with the CBM crew in here, we have some female crew members. And I don't want Get'em. I don't want to get him at all. There's certain topics you can't talk about.
Well, now you sound just like his birth parents.
So you don't want him talking to the crew at all now?
No. Oh, not okay. The crew.
Just certain members. Yeah.
The crew and the customers. There are certain topics I don't feel he should have any way, shape, or form should weigh in on, even if the topic comes up.
Like if they ask him, he's like, sorry, I'm not allowed to talk about
politics
that.
Is one.
Right, this is a place of business, so you don't want to alienate any.
Right.
Listen to me. Everybody support Trump, Hillary, their money spends, man. You got to get that money.
Right. And so, you must agree with that, correct?
What?
You must agree with, like, you don't deal on being out of
Deadpool.
Bounds here.
No. Right? No, yeah. You don't want to alienate the customers. I agree.
Or any of the staff, crew. The crew that's on here.
Yeah, they've been around for 6 years, man. You're the fucking new kid. That toothless grin's only going to go so far with them.
The charm.
Yeah. Hey, hold on, let me take my teeth out. There we go.
Okay, so you're not allowed to talk about politics. What else? Anything sexual, right?
I don't want him talking.
Because he was making weird sexual references at some point? He was talking about boners or something?
Were you?
No. I think I was doing like that's what she said type deal, and you were a little
I don't want you doing what that's what
too
she
risque.
Said.
Something on prime time on TV is like, it's like, you're filth. You're dirt. Get them.
Yeah, we come on. We all know what the joke means. There's no need to even try it.
Especially like ripping off what Steve Carell owns and has owned for fucking a decade. That's what you said, right? Am I right? Anything else? Anything else there's a lot to talk about? Off
the top of my head, I have to agree with whatever customer says is their favorite show.
Yes.
I know that's the same.
That's true. I forgot about that. I told him you do not give an opinion on any show unless awesome. It's positive. And if you and if it's not positive,
this
just say
is
you
amazing.
Haven't seen it.
I forgot about that one. That's so great. So somebody comes in and they're like, hey, this is the best show ever. And you're like, it definitely is.
Yes.
And then like on the tail of that, someone else is like, I like this show. And you're like, yeah, me too. Like that's what's expected of you?
That or say, I've never seen it before.
You have to deny.
Yeah.
Deny knowledge of it.
Why do you think that's funny? You don't think that's
because that's
great?
Not a real conversation.
Comic book shops are like the place where you're supposed to get in there and mix it up, you know, debate who would win in a fight.
Yeah, maybe not
which
politics.
Shows better, which mood is, yeah, politics.
Yeah, but if he's like, hey, I like Superman more than Batman, it's like he's on the unemployment line.
I don't know what comic book stores you've been frequently to, but if you, especially in today's climate.
Yeah.
It is very, very volatile to give an opinion on even on pop culture subjects as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I just don't want him getting in above his head, and, you know, and trying to
– right.
You know, and I know how he can get. He'll try to win the argument, and then winning at the argument at the cost of a sale though, or a future sale or a returning customer.
Right.
It's not worth it. Right. You just tell the customer, what do you love? I love it too. I've been doing it ever since I started here.
Yeah.
What's that? You like that? I like it too.
You know how I know Walt's a dear friend? He didn't seriously consider me for this job.
we're not allowed to demean Pokemon Go.
True. I told Nico. Yeah.
Well, this place is there were three kids sitting on a bench outside just fighting.
Yeah.
Now I might think it's stupid, and I might think it's like the sign of an end times, maybe.
It's the height of idiocy.
But I don't want anybody making fun at somebody coming in here who is
right.
grinning ear to ear, capturing. You know,
they got all their teeth.
They're having fun, and if they come in here, maybe they see something. They're like, oh, while they were capturing some fake monster.
Have you had a problem with people thinking Get Him is a monster and trying to catch him?
Yeah. So he's not the only one to tell that though.
Oh, Mike's not allowed to talk about Pokemon Go.
Nope. Nobody's allowed to talk
Mike
about
doesn't
it.
Like it?
Well, no, Mike does like it. He plays it.
No, but he
he'd start boasting about all the monsters he caught?
No, I just didn't want anybody slagging it off. Even an attempt at humor.
Oh, right.
You know, not everybody's as sophisticated as Get Him and Mike's humor.
Right.
They may not get the joke. They may not get
right.
the sarcasm.
Right.
Our Technicolor jokes.
A bunch of mouth-breathing Pokemon Go players walking
yeah.
around.
No. They're not going to get the
subtleties,
the high end fucking humor that these guys are bringing.
I mean, it's like Dennis.
That's
Miller,
what she said.
You know, they're, you know, they're the same.
Al Franken. I like that. It's those two and Dennis Miller.
Has anybody seen Dennis Miller in the past 10 years?
I forgot he was alive.
But have you ever seen Dennis Miller stand up?
I mean, love Dennis Miller,
it's
man.
Like
back in the day, he was
great. Yeah, you need a PhD to get some of the references he talks about. He's a very intelligent dude.
And didn't he get himself in trouble by opening his mouth at the wrong time?
Oh, well,
was
that Monday Night Football?
No, that was – what's his name? Wasn't it the other
no,
guy?
No, I know. Yeah, him too. But I think
Bill
Dennis
Maher.
Miller like
– Bill Maher was talking about
Dennis
how we
Miller
were cowards like
football,
right after 9/11.
He was a commentator on Monday Night Football.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah, he got kicked off pretty quick, right? Yeah. I thought it was because he wasn't funny.
It wasn't because
or
it just
people
wasn't
didn't
working.
Get it. Right.
Yeah, it wasn't working to have a comedian in the booth.
He was the Get Him of NFL.
We want Troy Aikman.
Yeah.
We want Bill Parcells.
Is Dennis Miller like him talk about politics? You have other people like you like, and don't slag off on Pokemon Go. Do the edicts come down daily? Like, is it hard to keep up with?
Yeah, they do. The words from the mount. It always come at a predetermined time. Stand there doing your job, and you just hear the thunder crash.
But truthfully, though, there's definitely I could shoot you looks now, and I don't even have to speak, right?
Yes,
and
yes.
You know exactly what I'm thinking.
Yes.
Shut the fuck up. It's the same every time.
But we're able to communicate on just the visual level now, yeah, right?
Yeah. Almost telepathically. It's one step away from telepathy, right?
I mean, try to think. Let me think of. Let me think of something. Something like some sort of food.
This is incredible. Okay. I want to try and take a picture of this if you guys don't mind, or quick, or let me just videotape this. If he gets it right, it's going to be crazy.
Well, you know what? Write it down and give it to Q.
All right, here we go. All right.
I need that piece of paper back. That's an ad for later. Blue juice ad coming up in a little bit, folks.
Yeah, so sit tight.
All right. Is it a food?
Yes.
Is it something you would eat for lunch?
Already, on it. Already got a food.
And like Walt's eyes are closed. He's like getting into it.
I would think it's got some salt in it.
Yeah, I have a little salt in it. Yeah.
So
would surf taco sell it?
Yes.
Chicken tender taco?
Yes.
Oh, yes! Yes!
Oh, my God.
Jesus.
Holy shit.
Oh, you up there. Yeah.
We're friends now. That's fucking amazing, man.
Wow.
What do you think of that, Q, huh?
Well, that just makes me worried for you.
It's not
a mind you want to be lost in.
You know what, though? It's a nice mind to visit, though. It's like you get in there and you're like, whoa. And you can come back out. You know you can leave if you want.
Do you remember when the Martian in jail in Justice League with Martian Manhunter went into Joker's mind and it was all like fucking funhouse mirrors and insane shit? That's what I imagine it's like. Like you made him sane for like 2 seconds. Oh, man.
Like political discussion and Pokemon sections are swelling, like they're overflowing. He's not allowed to talk about it.
Robin, I'm ready to burst. Just wanted to talk about something else.
The roads, the hallways, the pavement, Zippo's.
Independent thoughts swelling.
Now, you remember when I put the Ixnay on the political talk, because you were talking to a crew member about Abu Ghraib, right?
We were talking about Guantanamo.
Guantanamo.
Okay. Yes.
And did you see the response when you had your comment about Guantanamo? Did you see the back of that crew member straighten up? Did you see the neck tilt? Did you see the nostrils flare? And he was ready to just go at you.
And he's a fucking really intelligent guy.
What did you say? What was your take on it?
Because we were talking about how, you know, Trump would be so powerful if he got elected president.
Of course, he's president.
And I was like, well, look, I said, first thing Obama said he was going to do when he got into office was shut down Guantanamo Bay. Mm-hmm. Still open. And it's been how many years now? I said, you know, the president is pretty much almost – is a very powerful person, but they're at the mercy of the people – you know, the Congress.
Okay,
so why
is that controversial?
Because I saw the reaction. I didn't like it. I didn't like the reaction. I didn't like the reaction that
it was ready to escalate very quickly.
Right. I mean, and it does no good because I want people to love him.
Right.
And I don't think if he has any kind of opinion, you can love him. His real opinion.
That's for sure. Right.
You know, he has to just be like almost like a parrot.
Yeah.
Like when that conversation started like getting to a point where, which was very quickly where they were going to start yelling at each other, immediately she'd be like, so did you catch them all? And like just start fucking Pokemon Go's cock. He tried to defuse it with like, that's what she said, and it didn't work.
He's doing all his A material.
It's like, shit.
Flustered. He
took his teeth out.
He didn't notice.
Is it Friday?
TGIF, am I right?
All right, so Ginnam, what do you want to do with this thing? Or are we going to play a game where you are against a listener for what this is the prize? But we don't really.
I don't think we have a game ready to rock, though. Now it would be like an impromptu game, just
right.
You know what? I mean, he's had a rough day.
Yeah.
Would you have it in your within yourself?
Yeah, I mean, I gave him a fucking iPad last week. Why not give him a fucking toy this week? Jesus.
Thank you again for the iPad.
Here you go,
pal.
Did
someone give you an iPhone too?
Yes, this iPhone right here.
What the fuck? I mean, it literally. Tell him Steve Dave has been like stepping in the best pilot dog shit in your life, hasn't it?
Yes. Yes.
There you go. Get him.
Yeah, because I didn't have any room on my phone for my playlist, so they sent me the iPhone so I'd have room on here for my playlist.
What generation iPhone is it?
5.
Okay, so they had one laying around. Yeah. And they were like, let me give it to get him.
So
who was it?
Scott Noble on Twitter.
That's very nice of him. Thank you, Scott.
I'm pretty sure it was him. Yeah.
So has the iPad and that relieved the tension of the playlist issue?
Yes.
Oh, I got to tell you. Oh, boy. Now with some experience with this playlist, Walt. Most awful 90s fucking whiny crap. It's like I literally am like, when I come in and if I hear it, I'm like, turn it off. Like, I start fucking.
I switch over to Pandora now.
Let me get the playlist that
it's
you
It's Pandora.
Okay. Well, who are some of your favorite bands from the 90s? Some of that whiny.
It's Puss Rock.
It was Oasis.
Blink 182, Brand New, Taking Back Sunday, Bowling for
Today
Soup.
Today is going to be the
day. Well, that's Oasis, and they're a fucking classic band, so I don't agree with that.
Oh, God. But, like, everything's that whiny sort of, like, every band he likes, the guys are whining their way through the Paramore.
I mean, it still sounds like
your daughter likes that, yeah.
I wanted to ask you guys about this. I'm glad you brought up music and my daughter.
Well, that he is the musical taste of a 15-year-old girl.
No, well, Paramore doesn't fall in that category.
According to Pandora, it does.
Turn that shit off. You want to get us fucking a cease and desist?
I want to get your guys' opinion. I value your guys'.
Green Day, that's part of it.
Green Day has some good songs.
Yeah.
As a parent, what I should do here, next week.
Which daughter?
Alicia.
Okay.
She's 13, going to be 14
mm-hmm.
soon.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to – I told her, I promised her I would go see this performer she wants to see called Nicole Dolly Dahlenganger. And she is the opening act. Like, she's the opening act's opener. So she's going to play 6 songs. And then
Nicole Dahlenganger.
Dahlenganger.
She's going to play 6 songs? All right, I'm looking at her.
She looks kind of wholesome.
She's at N Baby Bell.
It's now she's really.
We got way more followers than her.
Nobody knows. Like she's virtually an unknown, and I like the fact that my daughter
in her face
doesn't. She's not into current. She's not into current music. She likes. She has her own.
She likes shit no one's ever heard of.
Yeah, and she. That's good. It doesn't bother her that nobody in the entire school knows who this performer is.
Right.
It doesn't matter to her.
Good for her.
But. Now we're going to see the other. Now the other.
Uh-oh.
Bands
is
in
this her with an S&M mask on?
There's some weird shit going on.
I don't know how I feel about that.
Now the opening. One of the opening act is called Teen Suicide.
Sweet.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm like, all right, probably just trying to be ironic, trying to get attention with that kind of very.
I hate that
like,
ironic shit.
You know, as we see, you're looking out. You're trying to find. You know, to make a name for yourself.
Sure.
But then the main act is called Elvis DePresley.
Elvis okay. DePresley.
Elvis DePresley with an album called Disgraceland. And I was like, that's pretty cool, I guess.
it's definitely rock and roll.
I'll be the judge of what's cool with 13-year-olds.
I mean, like, I kind of like the tone of like, oh, that's pretty funny, Elvis DePresley.
Right.
Disgraceland. But then when I went to listen to one of the albums on YouTube of Elvis DePresley, this is the YouTube video, and this is the image that plays the entire song, the entire time the song is on. And this makes me go like, what are we walking into when we come into this concert? It's a fucking picture of.
It's a picture of Elvis with a skull head. Oh, it says Elvis Hitler. and he has a Hitler mustache.
Yeah.
Oh, this is from the guy that brings up Hitler every single week.
I know. Am I being hypocritical here?
Well,
to be concerned about like what kind
this
of
this is from the guy who drew fucking the wild ass picture. Is
he? Yeah.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
You won my heart with that.
And she's a really good kid. She gets straight A's. She's so sweet. She's just a great kid. But now I'm like, well.
What would have happened if your parents tried to shut down your love of metal when you were a youngster?
That's why I tell my wife, and I'm like, look, I was smart enough to know it's a gag. It's art. It's when you're talking about these bands and these metal bands singing about Satan and everything, they're not Satanists. I knew it was all a performance.
Right. So do you credit your daughter with that same amount of insight?
I should, right?
You definitely should, because she's smarter than you at that age, for sure. There's no doubt about it. I knew you.
Why don't you – I don't have kids, but can I just make a suggestion? Why don't you just ask her?
About what?
Just like what
– She's like, I don't care about Elvis de Presley. I'm not there to see her – them. I'm there to see
Nicole
Dollinganger. But I'm like, but what about – but should we be at a club where Elvis de Presley is – performing though, I don't know what kind of like. Am I going to walk into like something we shouldn't be at?
Does her being the opening act mean that she endorses Elvis de Presley?
Well, you don't know the context. You don't know the context of what that drawing is. But
all right. Well, let me read some lyrics to you, Walt.
Okay.
Bring me to my knees. Her purity fucks with me. Weird honey. Boring ecstasy. Her sacred heart fucks with me. Weird honey. If there's a cool spot in hell, I hope you get it. If there's a cool spot in hell, I know you'll get it. Staying up all night, talking blasphemous ash, weird honey. Getting off on death, crashing heaven's trash, weird honey. If there's a cool spot in hell, I hope you get it. Okay.
This is I'm torn. I don't know what to do. I already brought the tickets. And she would be devastated if I was like, we're not going because of this. I wouldn't be the cool dad no more.
Where are they playing?
I know, and you're fucking teetering as it stands.
Brooklyn. I got to go back into Brooklyn.
Oh, man.
Oh, I thought it was down in Philly. So
I know.
Was that
there was two of them, and my wife chose the Brooklyn performance.
Holy shit. Where in Brooklyn, you know?
I don't know. Why is Brooklyn big?
Yeah, it's pretty big.
Pepsi Coke Suicide.
What's next Tuesday? Look up Elvis de Presley.
Okay.
Brooklyn.
All right. Let's fucking check this out.
And I don't know what the date is next Tuesday. Get him?
Second. The next Tuesday.
It's the 30th, right?
No, it'll be
It's August 3rd.
Yeah.
August 3rd.
Today's the 26th or 27th, isn't it?
No, because it's Thursday. Sunday.
Oh, here you go, Walt. The tour. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Look kind of old, these guys. Not real old, but
she's not into Elvis de Presley. It's the rest of the
August 3rd at the Market Hotel. Q. That's where the tour kicks off.
The Market Hotel.
That'll be Wednesday.
Well, she doesn't give a shit about these guys.
No, but
will you leave?
Because she wants to meet this girl who's going to come out. I guess and see some of the people who are there to see her.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
She wants to give her a present she bought her.
Yeah, I mean, she definitely knows the F word because Walt told me this. To tell that story, it's so great. This really made me laugh. And he told me and Ming, and both Ming and I jumped to the same conclusion.
So this performer, Nicole Dollinganger, she collects these porcelain dolls that look like the dolls from The Shining, the twins.
Okay.
That are these creepy dolls.
Okay, you know? Yeah.
I guess a lot of people, when they come see her when she's doing a performance, people who really like her will give you they want to connect with her and be like, hey, I really like your music. I got you a gift. And they give her a doll, and then she takes pictures of it with her collection. And
okay.
Stuff.
That's nice of her.
Kind of like what after the meeting, after the live show. With all the people coming down.
Yeah.
Except she doesn't throw the stuff in the garbage. Just kidding.
eBay.
And so I'm like – I look on eBay for some of these dolls, and they're like 50, 60 bucks. And I'm like, look, I'm not going to spend this much on a doll. I go, well, what we can do though is I've seen these dolls by the scads.
I'm sorry, but – would you like to speak with vocabulary from the century?
Scads, you say.
Well, you never heard that word?
No, I've heard it, but yeah,
that's probably black and white vocabulary.
I wanted to make a point.
Yeah, that's okay. She straightened up at that. She said, scads. Oh. Okay.
I didn't realize it was that much.
Or that little. What the fuck does scads mean?
So, and she hasn't gone with me to the flea market in years because she thinks it's dirty and useless, and she has no. There's nothing there for her, she says.
I think I remember last time I was there, last time I saw you, I think it was there.
Yeah. So it's been quite some years since she's gone with me to Florida. So this past week I said, I'll take you down here, get one for like $5. It'll look that vintage look and it'll be perfect. And I said, but we're going to go early. I said, if you get there late, forget about it. You won't find anything. So I told her I'll wake her up around 7. So I got up and I kicked in the door to wake her up because I wanted to get her all fired up. And I said, I go, come on, let's go. It's time to go. I go, because the effing flea market stands for fight, because you got to fight against the elements. It's going to be 90 degrees out there this morning. You got to fight against all the other people out there who are going to take the item that you want for more money. I go, you got to fight, 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 because the effing flea market – and her face was – because I've done this before at other times. So I wasn't expecting this reaction. Her face was horrified.
It's like the third time that week.
And I couldn't figure out. I was just like, whoa, what's the matter? Are you sick or something? I didn't know. I stopped.
She's horrified.
All right.
And she goes – and then she goes, oh, my God. What are you saying? She goes – and I go, well, I'm just – you know, getting you riled up. We're going to the flea market. You got to have the right mindset. And then my wife came and she goes, and she heard me from downstairs. She goes, why were you cursing? And I was like, cursing? I wasn't cursing. Goes, and then they figured it out. And they're like, oh, the flea market.
Right. As he's telling me this story, I'm like, why are you cursing at your kid? Like the same thing.
I got it.
It's so weird.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ming thought the same thing.
Because you even said the effing flea market stands for fight. Like, yeah. You can follow the sentence to the end.
You have to also understand, she just woke up 2 seconds ago. She's like, what? Is the house on fire?
So we get does the F stand for fire? What?
So we get to the flea market. It's a balmy 98 degrees.
It's 8 o'clock in the morning.
we immediately step out. She's like, I don't know if I could do this. It's brutal out here. And I was like, we're not going to give up. We're going to find it. And we found it rather quick. And so she's like, well, okay. We got it for $3. $3, the perfect doll. She's like, all right, let's go. And I'm like, whoa, I've only seen like a tenth of the flea market. Like, we're not leaving yet. I know you get up at 7 o'clock to come look down three aisles and go home. And she's like, well, I'm going back to the car with mom. So I'm like, all right, I'll meet you guys back there. I'm going to walk around a little bit. As I start to walk around, though, I start to feel the effects of the heat. I start to feel dizzy and everything. So I go back to the car, and I'm like, I really don't feel good. And I open the door, and I'm like, did you guys get any water, anything to drink? I don't feel good. And their response to me was, the effing flea market stands for fight, which you don't have any. And I'm like, I go, that's a good joke, but I'm going to die of heat stroke. You guys will give me some liquid.
Meanwhile, they're sitting in the closed car. They're not as hot as he is.
No, they had the air conditioner. Okay. Yeah, they had the car running.
Oh, wow. That
wouldn't let them out of the keys, just had the windows cracked a little.
That's brutal, man. You're like, I think I'm going to have heat stroke. And they're like, ha-ha. What's the effing flea market for?
It was a good shot.
It stands for fool. What do you think, though? Would you be concerned? Let's say you're going into a unknown.
Okay, well, listen to the lyrics from Nicole Dahlinganger.
I'm not worried about her so much.
Listen to these lyrics. I shot an angel with my father's rifle. I should have set it free, but I let it bleed. Made it into taxidermy, hung it on my wall.
That's pretty cool, man.
Those are lyrics that if Slayer – in 1984, if Slayer had that lyrics, I'd be like –
yeah.
Fuck yes.
It's fucking angel taxidermy.
Kill that angel. Yeah, where is he?
Well, let me at him.
Stop him on a wall.
I want to kill him. Right? I would not be concerned. And if my mom or somebody.
Kerry King, here's a figure for you.
Yeah. And if they were like, you can't listen to that, or I'm concerned, I'd be like, come on, give me some credit.
Yeah.
Give me some credit. You know I'm not a dope. I know it's just a
– I know you can't stuff angels.
They don't bleed.
Should I be like – be worried or concerned or about what we're walking into?
Are there usually other parents when you go to these things with her?
No.
Are they usually –
how does she feel about that?
It's a necessary evil.
Yeah. She's like, it's pointless to argue.
I wish I wasn't going with my dad, but if there's only way I can go, let's go.
Is the crowd around her age?
No. They're much older.
Just point at maybe like his parents let him go see The Who when he was 13 by himself. He was almost abducted from a bathroom, and look at him. So,
I mean, I definitely, and you know what? I'm glad that she's not like so like worried about like how she looks. That she's like, well, I really want to go, but I'm not even gonna do it because I have to go with my dad. It's not worth going. Mm-hmm. She doesn't care. She does not care. She'll still be seen.
Means to an end. She wants to justify the means.
Yes, and I totally support that. I know. I would be horrified if I was going into a concert with my mom at your age. I said, I know that you must feel pretty shitty right now, sitting here with me. But what else am I going to do?
What a heart to heart.
But I understand.
See, with my father, it was just always implied that it was shitty.
I go, I understand that this is not the that you'd rather be here, you know, and not without your dad.
But would she really? Like, if you just dropped her off, I'll bet you she would not want that either. Because
I don't know, but that's not happening either, though. Not at fucking Elvis Presley.
Well, that's what I mean. Like, if you were like one of these parents, it was like, go ahead. Like, she might be a little bit overwhelmed by
being alone. I think, yeah, she looks – I mean, she is 13, but she I don't think she looks 13.
She's tall. Yeah. She's pretty tall.
But I wouldn't – I mean, I just couldn't – I wouldn't feel so stressed out if I was like, okay, see you later. Hey, text me about how when Elvis Presley's over.
Yeah. Take the LIE back to Penn Station, Penn Station Middletown.
You need to use the bathroom. Stop my cues.
But yeah, I'm a little worried that the crowd might be a bit rougher than we're used to, because of the last concert we were at.
It was like I was moshed into unconsciousness.
It was Marina and Diamonds, and it was a very, very soft crowd.
Yeah.
Soft crowd. But
you think Elvis Presley, they might do you think they're just sitting around thinking about cutting themselves, or are they moshing, or like –
I don't know. That's I don't know what kind I'm of music it is. About. I wish I had one of my boys going up with me.
Yeah. I'll go. You want me to go?
Yeah. I mean, but I don't have to get your ticket, though.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they're not sold out, are they?
I don't know. I'll find out.
I'm there.
All right.
All right.
We can set – we can report back for Tom Steve.
Yeah. Should we bring our blazers? All right, more on that next week.
All right, can't wait to hear this report.
Yeah, how you think anybody's going to – anybody – you think it helps Elvis Presley and us talking about them? Any more units sold for them off iTunes?
What's a unit these days? Yeah, like a song on iTunes? Yeah. I'm sure they're like, yeah, your fucking audience is right around the age ours is. Thank you so much. I don't know. I mean, I guarantee most people right now are like, who the fuck is Elvis Presley and why are they talking about him for so long? Let's see.
You should bring Get Him.
Get Him. Just like whatever songs you guys like, I like too. Like, get the fuck out of here. I don't know. It's all these small bands. Oh, they're on where is this? Bandcamp. Yeah, $5 for an album. That's not bad.
That's not bad at all.
You can get – oh, my God. Oh, it's 8 releases. I thought it was 8. Oh, wait. No, I'm sorry. $14.40. $5 or
take
more.
Take it off, get him?
Yeah.
All right.
Take it easy.
See you in the morning, get him.
All right.
Now, is he allowed to still go to Reddit? Like on his off hours, can he go to Reddit or Twitter and give his real opinions?
I think it would be a wise move. I didn't make him yet, but I thought I suggested strongly that he should create a new persona online that no one knows, so that if he needs to get out any kind of like – anything that may be.
Yeah, so you're assuming he doesn't have 15 troll accounts already?
That won't work. He doesn't get that recognition.
Yeah, you're totally right. He needs people to know.
Is that true?
What?
You need recognition as Get Him, or else it's not as satisfying?
If you're on Reddit, you don't have the same amount of karma if you have an alternate account.
What?
What the fuck? It's meaningless, karma. It's meaningless, right?
Yeah.
Your job's in jeopardy here, bro.
You're right. Well, that's why I've been trying to be a lot more discreet online. So
yeah,
yeah.
But why is it still a hellhole? The Reddit or has it calmed
yes
down?
And no. But there was a nice comment on there about me working the other day. So
he was working. I'll take that.
No, it was an and they had a good time here. So you know they put it on Reddit that I did a good job.
Mm-hmm.
So.
I saw
no pops in the fucking store, but
I saw a lot of ants in San Diego, and I spotted him before he spotted me. A guy wearing a Four Color Demons jersey on the con floor.
Oh yeah,
yep.
Oh, they're out. They shipped, or
the,
he made his
no
own?
The vest like the pants.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah.
And one of the ants got me one of the Zippos from there.
Oh really?
With limited edition.
Oh
yeah.
cool.
So
are we out of patches on that?
We may be. I think they used all the patches up to make the jerseys.
Because I have a couple of people asked me about it. I was like, I don't know. I'll check. But I guess we
can reorder more patches.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Thank you again, Q, for the –
no problem. Yep. Take it easy, buddy. See you next week.
They've been around for 5 years. Elvis Presley. Yeah.
Well.
Yeah, they're just starting to come into their own. They've got 4 albums out.
Hey, it's a long way to the top, buddy, if you want to rock and roll.
If you want to rock and roll, man. That's true.
Speaking of, we saw Guns N' Roses last week.
Oh, yeah? How was that?
I got to say, man, it was pretty fucking good.
Pretty fucking good.
Yeah?
I mean, they were on point.
You took it back to the early 90s?
We were in Paradise City, bro.
Yeah. Slash played the Godfather theme for like fucking 10 minutes.
Yeah.
It was unbelievable. It was so good, man.
Was that a guitar-centric song?
Godfather? No, he made it, though.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was There Was No Shenanigans by Axl.
He seemed really happy. I mean – this has never happened to me before where I – oh, Billy Joel sometimes maybe when I see him, but like where like somebody's having such a good time where you're like, holy fuck, I'm actually having more of a good time because this guy's having a good time. He was into it, man.
Yeah, he was on.
Yeah, running around like fucking like it wasn't 100 degrees and humid out.
Yeah.
He didn't give a shit.
It's so weird you said Billy Joel. You're a big Billy Joel fan?
Yeah, I like Billy Joel.
I wanted to talk – I don't know if you were in the building. I'm going back – when I first moved to Highlands, I was at the community center. Do you remember?
Yeah.
He almost got into a major brawl over Billy Joel.
Okay.
I mean, if you knew this guy, you would be like, he'd get into a major brawl about anything pretty much. But Billy Joel is, that's odd.
The community center, I first moved there was a big older teen crowd that would monopolize the poker table.
Pool table.
Oh, yes. The pool table.
And, we were white trash. We weren't that white trash.
The younger kids would not be allowed to play until the older kids were done with the pool table.
Sure.
And and you're just being in the building, you always had to have one eye, like your head on a swivel, because one of those older kids was just as likely to shoot pool as also to pop you in the face for no reason. Okay. These are the kind of kids they were.
Right.
Ruffians.
This is Jersey in the
Scallywags.
80s. Early 80s.
There's no fucking around back then.
And so everyone's
– no safe space.
Yeah, there was no –
we didn't need them.
Yeah.
You took your lumps and you moved on.
And you gave it to someone else and then you moved on.
I remember this vividly because I remember being in awe of this because I was just like, I can't believe that this is what
– he's going to the mat for Billy Joel.
These guys are willing to fight over. So there's this one older dude is playing pool against another older dude. And these dudes look like – and I'm saying like they're teenagers. They may as well look like they were 30.
Yeah, they look like adults. Yeah. They had mustaches and shit.
They had beards and mustaches. They didn't look like they were 17. They looked like they were 37.
All right.
Snoogans!
We're so fucked. We're like Pavlov's dogs.
And the topic came up about the Stones because everybody had the patches on their backs.
Remember? The Rolling Stones, the lips.
Yeah, the lips tongue. Or Zeppelin.
Right.
And the topic of music came up. There was a jukebox in that room, as I recall, in the early 80s. And the argument came – somehow the discussion turned around who was better, like, you know, Jagger or Plant.
Mm-hmm.
And this one dude, while shooting pool, just goes, "You're all fucking wrong. The best songwriter and singer alive is Billy Joel."
Okay.
And he took his shot, like you know, as if like he would like the
punctuated.
Room,
punctuated, yeah.
And stood up to be like, "Who the fuck is going to disagree with that?" And there was one other hardhead there that was like started laughing and like antagonizing him, going, "He goes, Billy Joel. He goes, you can't hold up a candle to Jagger or Plant." And they got like so close, spinning at each other, going like, "Say fucking Billy Joel's not the best singer again, and you're fucking dead." And like it was madness. Like, and these guys weren't on drugs or anything.
Well, as far as we know.
I mean, they're nose to nose, so angry. One guy took a pool stick. It was like he was going to hit him. He's like, "Come on, go ahead, fucking hit me with it. I'll kill you if you hit me with it."
This is where we hung out after school as 12-year-olds.
And just sitting here going. Like if I don't leave now, I could get caught up in this for some reason. Yes. What if they say, what do I think?
Am I pro or con Billy Joel? That's where you learned. Like, don't fuck it off your musical taste. Whatever you guys like.
Like Piano Man, he's the best.
He also sucks, you know. Mick rules. Piano Man. Yeah, that's a weird fucking
but this is
hill
like
to die on, the Billy Joel hill, right?
81, though, that Billy Joel was probably at the top of the world. He probably was the male performer of the sure. year at that point.
Well, I don't even think they're so different in tone. How do you even compare the two?
Stairway to Heaven.
Yeah, I mean, you can make the argument that Billy Joel is the best songwriter in his class.
Let's see.
In that argument, would you slam a pool stick over someone's face to make that argument?
like it was nothing.
I mean, they were that close. I mean, they had to be separated. They were so angry about it. And they took it so seriously.
You ever replay arguments in your mind years later? You ever do that? I do that. I wonder if those two motherfuckers ever like
never
that fucking bitch.
Not these two guys. No, they probably don't. They don't remember it as vividly as I do.
Well, you got to understand, Coey was coming hot off of Glass Houses. You may be right. Don't ask me why. It's still rock and roll to me.
Hey, I mean. He was like
he had a string
of hits, right?
Well, it was great, man. I'm not complaining.
But he threw it out there as if he knew saying it, like he just wanted a rumble.
Yeah, like as if he was stating a fact.
So angry about it. And I remember my good friend, my boss, Timmy Hill, came in a young, you know, and I was
like, Walt, one day someone's going to ask your opinion.
just want to pull you across the face.
And he had to be the voice of reason and separate those guys and try to tell them, you know, like, hey, you know you're right. But you may be wrong.
That's what he said?
Yeah, he made a joke about it, and it kind of diffused everything. And
Timmy Hill is in the hospital for the next 2 weeks.
Yeah, and those guys, you know, those guys did like do the slap the hands, like we're cool, don't worry about it. Hey,
music is passion, man.
Is it though?
Sure.
That I mean, that's passion? Yeah. Like I don't think you're going to see that at Elvis to Presley. Like you should be like, hey, why? Where is Billy Joel opening? Here comes the pool cue. Guns N' Roses queue.
Yeah.
New Jersey. 30 people were arrested.
Oh, shit.
And remember the person who was assaulting the state trooper? And we were talking about it, and I was like, what makes people do shit like that? And you're like, alcohol. It was actually a woman who did it.
Well, I'm sure she
– She's 30-year-old Kimberly Goodman.
Sure she was drunk too.
She aggravated assault against two state troopers, and then there was an arrest for solicitation without a permit, disorderly, criminal trespassing, simple assault, drugs, resisting arrest, open lewdness. Oh, yeah. And harassment.
How old?
They just say the age of the one girl who was 30 who hit the two cops.
No.
There was nothing like that in Philadelphia.
No.
As far as we could see.
No. Everybody was getting along fine where we were.
Yeah.
You would recommend to anybody listening, though, get out and see them?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It was great.
Yeah.
It was great.
One of those bands that, like, I mean, I won't go so far as to say bucket list, but one of those bands that I'm like, I wish I saw them back then.
Yes.
But seeing them now is
– good enough?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It was fine.
That's cool. It didn't feel like they lost a step.
Fucking mowed down really? By the youngins.
Yeah. Is there a chance they will record a new album based off this reunion?
I will say this, and Brian, tell me if you agree with – they didn't seem very warm towards each other on stage.
It seemed to me like Slash and Axl were on opposite sides of the stage. Like whenever one came over, the other one would go to the other side or Axl really? Rose would go
but
up
even
the middle.
Guitarist never really did that back-to-back thing. You know?
Yeah, like the bassist and the rhythm guitarist, whoever he is, they seem to have a little bit of rapport. But yeah, Slash was – I mean he's Slash. What a fucking cool guy. Nobody rocks a top hat. No. Even magicians can't rock a top hat like Slash.
My when I was in San Diego, I was hanging out with the director. This guy we call Director Pete. He directed like two seasons of Practical Jokers. And his son goes to school with Slash's kid. And 2 years ago, Slash put one of his hats up for sale in an auction. And it went for $1,400. And I was like, why the fuck didn't you just buy it? For $1,400, you would have been able to fucking – one, I would have worn it everywhere.
Yeah.
Like I would have just fucking worn it everywhere. Two, like you could have sold that around. It came with a certificate of authenticity.
Speaking of top hat, didn't I wear a top hat last week?
That's true. Yeah, the Baron and Slash. You're right.
Maybe I could flip that hat for, you know
– $1,400?
I don't know about $1,400, but I'd take five.
Q signature.
$500.
Sal signs it. Q signs it. Get him doesn't sign it.
We got an ad, Fry.
Are we wrapping up? Because
No. But one day okay. And do what you want to talk about. Because I mean, I promised Blue Juice about a half hour ago, and I'm sure people are like.
Yeah, people are just like they tuned out. They're like, look, if they're not, they're just going to taunt us with Blue Juice ads and not fucking deliver. Our friends at Blue Juice Comics have a new book out. We've gotten copy from Blue Juice. They're telling us what to say. We're under strict. We're not to offer opinions.
Well, they help us out a lot, so I'm happy reading what they want to read.
This is Ether and Empire, Walt?
Yeah.
And they spell it fancy like Tool, right?
Yeah, that's right. That is like the Tool kind of spelling.
Mm-hmm.
Anima, right? Anima.
Yeah. A steampunk adventure at the height of Victoria's reign, a scientific expedition to Mars. That is long. Come on.
Do you like steampunk?
I do. I do like steampunk. No, I mean, I'm not into it.
It's kind of like, to me, it feels like an irony.
Yeah. Because now everyone. I mean, no, I hate it. Yeah, I'm undecided. I'll get back to you.
It's popular, though, right?
Yeah, I like the designs of certain things. I mean, I'd never go so far as to wear like steampunk glasses or steampunk pants or whatever people make.
Fine line between cool and corny when it comes to steampunk.
Yeah.
Too many people cross over that line.
And Blue Juice has walked that line. Oh, yeah. Like,
so they're not solidly on the side of cool. You're like, they're almost corny.
They're actually on the other side of cool. They're so far.
They're on the right side of cool. Yeah, oh, Blue Juice, we'll sell that to you. Blue Juice Comics on the right side of cool.
Jules Verne meets Star Trek and Ether and Empire, a tale of adventure, mystery, and terror from Blue Juice Comics. Go to www.shopbluejuice.com to buy Ether and Empire issues 1-4 in print, or go to www.comixology.com to get issues 1-5 digitally.
So why can't you get – is 4 not in print yet? I mean 5 not in print?
I guess 5 hasn't come out in book form. But listen to this.
This is, you're going to find this particularly interesting.
All right, I'm ready to go.
Oh, I thought you were going to say it.
last week, Ether and Empire was nominated for Best Independent Comic in the Spacey Awards. Blue Juice would like to thank the ants for showing up in droves and helping them get 60% of the vote. Ants came through again, as usual.
Can't beat a swarm, man.
While it was nice to tweet it and see your friends, you know, win or you know, or get 60% of the votes, to me, equally as satisfying is thinking of the guys who, like, slowly realized they had no chance and the crushing of their dreams. Like, I started getting hard when I was thinking about it. That was sweet.
Nice.
I mean, that's what you can count on. You can count on death, taxes, and the ants to come through, Q.
That's right.
They come through, man. They're all right, the ants. Seriously. Q?
Yeah.
Somebody's probably breaking into your house right now.
Why?
There's a home burglary every 13 seconds.
Oh, shit.
In the world or in America?
Not in Staten Island.
Not in my house. You know how I know not in my house?
How? How could you possibly
know
that?
I don't even
know
what ad you just broke into, but I will tell you this. I have 3 Nest cams outside my house and the Ring doorbell.
Okay.
So what's a Nest cam? It's like a fake bird? A bird's nest? No.
It's just the name
of it.
With
a camera in it?
It's just the name of it. Look at this.
Like 2 cameras for eyes. People are like, what the fuck is that?
That's the weirdest looking bird
it's
ever.
Like, it's like that owl from fucking Clash of the Titans.
What is that, Bebo?
Yeah. See, that's the front of my house is covered. I got the sides.
Wow. Well,
that's back. Some big ass fucking iron gate right there. Is that an iron gate? What am I looking at there?
That's the railing.
No, this, it looks like, oh, you took it through a screen.
Yeah,
it's a screen. Oh, okay. It's like, holy shit.
It looks like a fucking castle. It's like, where's the moat, motherfucker?
No. So I'm covered.
He's fucking pouring hot fucking oil on people at the mailman every morning.
Sounds like,
believe me, it's coming. Is it the ring?
It is the ring.
Oh, yes. Let me tell you something. It definitely makes me feel, if a fucking, if a sparrow farts on my property, Walt. I have it down on video, and I know it happened. And the ring
the
is an
cops are like, we can't keep taking these reports.
The ring is an essential part of that. I can attest. I do use this.
Do birds have gas?
Oh, they got it, right?
I don't think so.
I thought they just blew up. Like that's why they say don't throw rice because they eat the rice and then they blow up and they can't fart it out.
I don't know about that. Either way, I love this fucking ring. It's great.
Can birds fart? Too bad Gidim isn't here.
Yeah.
For a limited time, listeners get $50 off the Ring of Security kit. If you go to ring.com/TESD, hundreds of thousands of people are using it, Walt.
Oh, yeah.
Do you use it?
Yes, I have one too. Mm-hmm. I have just one. I don't have the security system. It doesn't look like Abu Ghraib at my house like Q's house.
Yeah.
With all his cams.
With all his screens and everything. Get him
jealous of his cam.
Yeah.
None are inside my house. Actually, that's not true. There's 2 inside my house.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Do you alert people that they're on?
Well, no. What happens is when I come home.
That's what you need, like a PA where you can be like, oh, can't you do that through the ring? You can like say something to
you
them.
You can. You can talk to
like, fuck off, weirdo.
Yeah. I just pretend I'm not home. But the Nest cams, I know this is for the ring, not Nest. But when it senses that I'm home, it shuts the ones inside the house off.
Oh, okay.
Automatically, yeah. The Ring's a great product, though. I fucking love it.
I agree.
There you go. Ring of Security. Yeah. Ring.com/TESD. T-E-S-D. Q.
Yes.
Indochino.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't understand this. What are you speaking?
Indochino, Walter. Like Indochino.
Italian here.
Huh? Fucking love
Indochino.
I had the best experience there.
This is a new
process. I had the worst.
Is this the first time we're ever doing this?
Yeah, this is the first time we're doing it. Indochino is an online, and they have stores as well. That's where I went to get fitted custom suit makers, Walt. And I just recently had a suit made by them, and it's fucking awesome.
Made out of what?
Mine's like a linen cotton blend.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Right. I thought you could just bring like I want a suit made out of, I don't know, like felt.
These females?
No.
All of my fans' drawings, I'd like a suit made out of the bins. Can you do that in Indochino? Yeah. No?
Okay. Let's see. Made-to-measure suits are now affordable and available to the masses, like us, Q.
Yes.
How it feels. Well, we can't talk about how it fits and feels because we haven't gotten our suits yet.
What does Indochino mean?
I don't know.
Suave.
Yeah, I think it means suave in Italian. Indochino.com with the promo code TESD for any premium suit. $9 and free shipping. I'll tell you what I didn't like about the experience because I went to the same place you did.
You went
to
Manhattan?
Yeah. It's a bunch of really in shape gay guys judging me the whole time.
Did they judge you?
Yeah, I'm sure. Like stylish,
that's
too.
Just in your head.
Yeah, they're all stylish.
They all looked like real – like they look like I would want to look.
What do you need a suit for?
Me?
Yeah, why do you want a suit?
The funerals?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, God, really? That's why you – that's like
– I figure somebody's going to die or more likely I'll die and then I'll be buried in something nice from Indochino.
Did you get like the custom lining on your suit and the back? I got a vest. Did you get a vest?
Of course.
I went 3-piece. Well, yeah. I'm feeling good about myself. I got it monogrammed on the inside.
Really?
It says Colonel Brian Quinn on the inside.
What if I were to tell you mine says Pops Johnson?
Well, I'd be impressed, my friend. I would be impressed.
You know what Indochino should look into? And I'm going to throw this out to try to make up for that that horrible comment that Brian made. An idea for them, what they should do. And I mean, this is a serious idea. I just had this, and I think this is brilliant. Maybe I shouldn't throw it out to Indochino.
Yeah, well, let's use it for our suit company.
You know how they in the bat suit, like the bat flex suit, they have the muscles? Why don't they do that with suits, like fake muscles?
I'd like something that would make me even bulkier.
No. With today's technology, you could look like, you know, like you're like pumping iron.
How much for a Batman suit? They're like, what?
No. You know what I'm saying? With the nice suit, with this nice felt or whatever it is they use. Not felt, but
– Yeah, the felt suit. Go ahead.
Well, whatever they make it out of. Polyester?
Merino wool, son.
A wool suit.
Yeah.
You just stitch muscles in there.
Yeah.
And you look cut. And you put – and then you can put maybe like if your derriere is not as – puffy as it should be. Mm-hmm. Or you got – maybe
like them puffy
come with
suits.
A rubber ass.
You got sad thighs maybe. Yeah. You don't have the big thighs.
Sad.
You know, you want some Earl Campbell thighs.
Yeah, all right.
What do you think?
Sounds like it would be hot.
Would you be embarrassed to wear
and expensive.
Fake muscles under your suit?
I would be embarrassed. I'd rather just –
like inflatable muscles?
Yeah.
It's almost as ridiculous as like when I walked in and like they knew I was there for the podcast. I'm like – are these guys being like, this is the face of our company? What the fuck? This fat asshole?
You know? No, I'm not kidding. I'm surprised that really hasn't been done, don't you think? Or do you think it hasn't?
Not really. You know how expensive that would be?
Very hard to make it look realistic.
With today's tech?
How are you sewing muscles into a suit?
What do you mean?
You just said sew muscles into the suit.
Yeah, it's just like you just have these like –
like ball up some felt and just sew them in.
You just have – like you know how they can make the bat suits now, these superhero suits. You know how everybody looks like they're super fit?
Yeah.
Why can't they do that for a nice business suit?
Well, one, those suits are kind of skin tight. So the fabric's not going to move around when your muscles like move it. And what happens when you get to a meeting? You take your jacket off.
Yeah, my suit's made out of spandex.
I don't know. There's just a thought.
They're reinventing men's fashion, and a made-to-measure suit is the best suit you will ever own. So suit up, Q.
I can endorse this one without – this is like my vanilla granola of clothing.
And you know what? They didn't fiddle with our junk.
No.
They did not fiddle with that junk.
No.
They didn't even ask me which way. Yeah.
They didn't even ask which way it falls.
It hangs, yeah. Which way do you dress?
Yeah, they didn't ask that.
They don't care which way your junk goes.
They weren't talking in code.
Yeah.
Nothing like that. So Indochino.com, promo code TSD.
Like you could get the lining of the suit. You could pick a pattern for it. And then also, like, if you get a vest, you could get that same pattern on the back of your vest. And then, like, on the interior of your collar. Like, it's – they really – like, you have a lot of ways to customize the suit and make it your own. Like, the monogramming. You pick the colors of the stitching on the suit.
Wow.
It's really cool, thorough. Dude. I had a lot of fun with it.
How long were you there?
Half hour, 45 minutes.
45 minutes it took.
Yeah.
Somewhere around there.
But the suit, well, it's going to last a lifetime.
Mm-hmm. As long as we don't get fatter.
Right.
Indochino.com, T-E-S-D. So it's been a while that we've had this. So today's we're recording on Tuesday, right? Is today Tuesday?
Today is Tuesday.
So we're going to go two for Tuesday.
Oh, shit.
Fat news. Ooh, chicken.
All right, so wow. Fat news, boys.
It's back.
Okay, we got two. Yeah.
There hasn't been any fat news, there's been nothing to catch your interest?
Yeah, not really. I mean, not that I saw, but then within the past 2 weeks, two stories popped up that I feel is worth addressing, and I'm curious as to your opinions on these very timely issues, mostly about shaming other people. So this is almost 2 weeks ago now, but tough shit. Playmate fat shames a woman at gym on Snapchat. Okay. So this Playmate girl.
Right.
She tweets or Instagrams or something, Snapchats, I guess, this picture,
she
right?
She took a picture of a woman in a shower?
Of herself, yeah, and a naked woman in the locker room.
I mean, isn't that roundly illegal?
Well, that's what she eventually found out. I mean, she found it out pretty quickly, actually. So she tweets this picture, this Danny Mathers, right? She posted a photo of a naked woman in her Los Angeles gym to Snapchat this week to fat shame her. The woman didn't know she was being photographed. It says, if I can't unsee this, then you can't either. And there's like a picture of her like, tee-hee, like, you know.
Right.
In the foreground because so the fat lady who's at the gym trying to better herself. Right.
Yeah.
It took all of 2 seconds for social media users to rain scorn down onto the comely Playmate.
Good.
But she also faces for her crime against common decency.
Real charges?
Real charges. Yeah, you're not allowed to do that. I mean, yeah, she got banned from every – what gym was this? Like 800 different outlets. Like she's banned for life from whatever gym she was in. I forget which one it was. And
it's just another example of the beautiful and privileged thinking they could do whatever the fuck they want.
Well, here's what I thought, because she's like, you know, she's like, oh, if you can't unsee us, I can't either. And she has like tee-hee, like, you know, with the hand over the mouth. This girl is and has been probably for her whole life so attractive that no guy was ever like, you're not funny.
What's her name?
They just laughed at her stupid fucking jokes in the hopes of getting their hands in her pants and just like led her for 30 years. You know, the girl's like 30 years old, 29, 30, to believe that what she was saying was actually funny. So she has no idea.
That's not defense.
What's her name?
Oh, no. No. I'm just saying.
Her defense can't be, well, I was so pretty that no one told me I wasn't funny.
What is her name?
Danny Mathers, D-A-N-I. She apologized in a video saying it was absolutely wrong. It's definitely no excuse. But I'm saying that, like, it's a rude awakening at this point where it's like, oh, so I'm not funny. I will get old.
But what is the mindset of somebody who's like, oh, let me post this. I'll be beloved. I'll get some yucks. People will love this.
I think that's it. People will think it's funny.
So fucking mean-spirited. Yeah. Like, why?
I have chosen to do what I do for a living because I love the female body, and I know that body shaming is wrong, and that's not what I'm about. Yeah.
Yeah, hello.
Yeah, you love the female form.
That's her?
Uh-huh. Yep.
Well, I'm seeing the humor in it now. I'm kind of seeing her side in this story.
You know, funny is subjective.
Everyone's got their own sense of humor. Let's not be hasty.
She goes, I will never do this again. You have my word. Well, no shit. I mean, she had to cancel every social media account she had.
Good.
Because people are just like, fuck you.
Good.
And people are not like – and I don't know that this many people care about the woman as much as they care about fucking going after someone, regardless if she's pretty or not.
I think that there's definitely people love to call people out on the social media too. Mm-hmm. There's a certain level of satisfaction that
– they love to get sanctimonious about shit. Do.
But in this case, Madonna. You know what? Oh, well. You get what you deserves.
She's got giant fake tits, too.
Your biggest accomplishment is showing your junk for cash, and you have the nerve to mock an innocent woman who's just trying to take a shower at the gym. You put her nude body on the internet. Now, that's the big problem.
That's the bigger, big-ass problem.
Okay, yeah. It's LA Fitness booted her out. She got kicked off of the show, suspended indefinitely from
the show?
The Heidi and it's a radio show, Heidi and Frank. I guess she made regular appearances. And LA Fitness said she's not allowed it back at any club ever because they could get sued. I'm sure.
Wait a second, though. That maybe led credence to maybe she's more funnier than you think, because a radio show would have no interest in somebody who wasn't funny just because they were pretty, though. So that maybe there she does have maybe she has more of a sense of humor than you might think, right?
If that's an example of it, though.
Well, that's just mean, though.
Yeah. And I'm not about like – I mean I'm okay with being mean at times. But that's like – I wouldn't – like not a million – like it would never even occur to me to do something like that. And I'm in the women's locker rooms a lot.
Did anybody stick up for her?
Not that I can see.
No. Why wouldn't they? That's horrible. It's a horrible thing to do to someone. Like how's that person supposed to feel?
I mean I don't think it occurred to her like – I wonder how she'll feel after this. I mean, anyone with half a brain would know that she's not going to be too happy. And she didn't even bother like she just had to do it immediately. And that's how you suss out morons on the internet is like they can't help themselves. So they just tweet this shit and send this shit out regardless of the content. You know, like she could have easily done, like what's it called? Like Microsoft Paint or something and like cover the woman's face up or blur it or whatever. But no, has to like send it to me. Oh, look how fat she is. I'm fucking 30. Like, what a fucking idiot.
I'm 30.
Just like a mean-spirited fucking
hashtag
dope.
I'm 30.
A hot, mean-spirited dope.
Yeah, I mean, you can't take that away from her. Yeah, she doesn't look bad.
But you know what? Her looks are going to fade and she'll still be a shitty person. She'll still be a shitty old person.
Do you think she really regrets it or she just regrets
the backlash? She fucking regrets
it. No, I mean, like, does she feel remorse or does she just regret having done it?
She regrets having done it because of the reaction.
Yeah, I don't think she has remorse for having that inside of her.
Yeah.
It's very difficult, like, when you're under that much fire to be like, let me take stock of myself as a person.
Well, that's what she said she's going to do. She was like, I'm going to take some time to examine why I would do it.
That's
like,
good.
Everyone already knows why you would do it.
Because you're an asshole.
Yeah, because you're an asshole. That's the why you would do it.
But do people deserve second chances?
Yes.
Depending on the crime.
Okay.
Molest a kid, bullet to the back of the head.
Oh, well, yeah, that of course. That's not
boom.
I'm telling you, I think he means more of social media second chances.
Well,
right?
Like Mel Gibson, does he deserve a second chance?
I think so.
Yeah, I think
well,
so.
Well, that's because you love lethal. You're hoping for another lethal weapon.
What's the offense? I can't remember. There's so many things he did, right, that were wrong.
He was real anti-Semitic.
Yeah, well, but was also with his wife, too, his ex-wife.
There were hints that he physically abused his wife, but nothing proven.
I thought he was just yelling at her because she didn't blow him before going in the hot tub like she promised.
She promised him?
He said that she promised that she was going to blow him before she went in the hot tub, and then she didn't fulfill her end of the bargain, and he was all worked up about it.
He blew up about it?
Oh, yeah. He exploded. He was like, it's worse than Billy Joel. Yeah, there's marshmallows and shit. Yeah. Like, I don't know. Somebody like him, I'm just indifferent to. I'm like, you want to forgive him? Go ahead. You don't want to? I don't give a fuck.
There should be some sort of online tribunal. That you could bring your case to, like to be forgiven for your sins on the internet.
Yeah, but the people right? aren't going to forgive him publicly. People sitting behind their keyboard, the type of people that are sitting behind their keyboards judging everybody are not going to forgive him.
I can understand why though. I can sympathize with people who are like, no, I can't forgive him. It was too.
Yeah, but
gross.
if he was an alcoholic like they said he was at the time, like isn't it a sickness? And didn't he take steps to –
why are you shaming him for his illness?
Yeah, so it's just like
– but you don't think that there should be some sort of like online like we all have to abide by their ruling of like, you know what? Leave this person alone. They suffered enough. They're ostracized enough. When they go online, leave them alone.
I don't think that
– support them.
There's no way.
The social justice community will not come down on his side.
Right, but if they – but like we feel – we weighed the time that he's been ostracized by the online community. We feel that he or she has paid a sufficient price for their actions. Let's love them. Let's support them. Let's give them tweets of encouragement, and let's move on.
What did you do that you're trying to get rally the support for assholes?
I just want to be on the tribunal.
All right.
Oh, good. Okay, so she did apologize, this girl. What did she say?
No, it's too soon for her if I'm on the tribunal. She's got to wait a little bit longer.
Well, she's 30. Oh, wait a second. Much more time to wait.
Well, first she said – okay, here you go. First she said that she did it accidentally – that she meant to –
honey.
She was new to Snapchat and it was only meant to be viewed by her friend.
That doesn't make it any better of you being a horrible person.
Yeah. Well, that was damage control right there.
Yeah.
I mean, isn't this a woman who in all likelihood fucked Hugh Hefner, the 90-year-old fucking Methuselah?
Do you think Hugh Hefner's fucking anybody anymore?
Maybe finger blasting.
Do you think he cares? How could he care? Yeah. How many fucking blasts of your fingers do you need before?
I don't think
those skeletal fingers inside you.
Cold, clammy skeletal fingers inside you.
You're just like holding a mirror under his nose while he's finger blasting you. Making sure he's still alive. You.
Hugh, honestly, it probably would have been best for him if he had died like 10 years ago before he saw his empire just fucking crumble.
And turn into non-nude Maxim-type entertainment.
Actually, the magazine is pretty good now.
Is it?
I kind of like the change.
Oh, I have no knowledge of this.
Yeah, no more nudity.
In Playboy?
Yeah, for a couple like issues now, right?
Yeah.
And has it helped the sales?
It has. It helped the sales and advertisers it helped.
The demographic they're going after are like millennials who – have a job and don't care about naked puss, I guess.
Well, I mean, their point was like you used to see fucking porn anywhere on the internet anytime. Right. There's no point to it.
It makes it easier to sell Playboy. I guess.
But they actually changed the physical format. Oh, they use better paper now. It's a different thing. I actually like it now. It's pretty cool.
Did they start over with a new number one just like the comic books would do?
No, they did not do that.
That was foolish.
But it's pretty good though.
What issue are they up to on Playboy? It's got to be in the millions, right?
Jesus, I don't know.
Well, if it's been around, let's say it's been around 65 years now. 12 times 65 would be 650, 130. So
780? Oh, that's it? Not even 1,000 issues yet? What about –
there's only 12 issues a year.
Now, right? Do you think he had a say in this change or do you think it was a board of directors?
They went to him with it and he –
What? Come here so I can finger blast you. I'm a male, sir.
He approved it. I think his only – I think he just he had something about how he still wants cartoons in it or something like that.
But he's like, don't take the party jokes out. Whatever you do,
there's gotta be.
Are you gonna
secretaries
remove?
Running around a desk?
Yeah, are you gonna remove the funnies?
Yes.
Are they holding off to remove the cartoons?
Right there, being ageist, right there. What we just did. Are we no better than that? Pretty dope.
Well, he's a public figure.
It's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay then.
We can lampoon him. Okay, but we can skewer him.
I don't think it's as mean as some woman in the shower just trying to make a life better.
Isn't it all about perspective? Poor Hef's listening to this right now. He's just downloaded the new Tell Him Steve Dave. You just get this.
Better than the cartoons even. Let me listen. Oh no. Too old to hump. Did they? To all the finger blast, would I? All right. And number two.
Okay.
Okay. Now, who doesn't love a plus size supermodel?
Everybody loves a plus size supermodel.
Of course. She's getting body shamed. Q.
They're shaming a we're still in the habit of shaming plus size supermodels?
Well, when former fatties go thin, it's reverse. Sizest action wall.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Plus size supermodel Ashley Graham is getting body shamed by haters for losing weight after flaunting her slim figure in a photo on Instagram.
But isn't that's a health thing, isn't it? Like being fat is not healthy. I get you got to be accepting of it and fucking not fat shaming people. Fine. I'm totally with that. But what, are we to sit here and pretend that it's not healthier to be fucking thinner?
That you're not at risk for high blood pressure.
Don't flaunt it, though.
Diabetes.
Don't flaunt it.
But she's a model.
That's a
Are
job
you telling me not to flaunt my fucking curvy figure?
Well, no, she didn't do
I'm
it.
Audacious.
She was flaunting on her own social media, right? Lie.
What's that?
Was she flaunting it in an ad where she was paid to
be
pose
a fatty?
It, or was she flaunting it on her own private like account?
Paid to be a fatty, the Brian Johnson story.
But wouldn't the argument be like, even if she was putting skinnier pictures of herself on a private account, she's promoting a healthier lifestyle?
Take in consideration how it's going to make others feel, for once.
Okay, so here's the thing. Some people are claiming
but promoting
that,
a healthier lifestyle, that's not a matter of emotions.
But yeah, but take in consideration how it's going to make other people feel.
Well, all the fatties are like, oh, we had her. Now she's gone.
But who cares how
now she's
them
now
feel?
She's with the beautiful people. Yeah, you know what? Fatties lose fucking weight.
You're talking to me.
I'm talking to me.
I could stand to lose like 20, 25 pounds.
I could lose weight too. And
sure. You know,
I take blood pressure pills in the morning. Why?
What's up?
Fat.
What's up, fatty?
Yeah.
How your pills doing?
Yeah. People are going to get pissed if I lose weight. Is that what I'm hearing? It's better to stay fat?
It's not better to stay fat. Everybody
haters
should
coming
be
after me.
Healthy.
Well, no, but if your soapbox was I'm a plus size model.
Right. Mm-hmm.
It is.
And now you run – You run to the other side, and now you're like, well, now I'm not anymore. You know,
well, is she a skinny mini? I mean, what are we looking at? Well, did she
she's still like – I mean, she's got big boobs. She's like
– she's still got meat on her.
Yeah.
That's the after photo?
That's the after photo, yeah.
She's still got
Here, I'll meat. Show you the before. She's a very pretty face. Look at her.
I mean
– there she is with her fucking badunkadunk.
That's pre-weight loss.
That's pre-weight loss right
All
there.
Right.
All right.
Okay. I could see how people would say she's got like ham hockish arms. I see it, but she's still extremely attractive.
Did you sell cutie after?
Yeah. There she is.
She's
after.
Attractive both ways. She's just healthier this way.
And let's face
by
it.
By society standards.
No,
healthier.
By medical science
standards.
We don't know that to be true.
Yes, we do.
Oh, don't do it. You've been so good this whole
time. Kidham's not here to back you up.
Kidham has told me that a little meat on your bones does a lot to stave off disease.
That fat
Says
fuck.
The guy who's fucking 150 pounds overweight.
Yeah, has, better not be given any advice. Okay, yeah. I've been telling him to stop eating fried food for a year now.
Yeah, he's eating like Walt's able to guess fucking chicken fried tender tacos or whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
People said, I knew you did it to lose weight. No, I knew you did it. I knew it. The punctuation is awful. I knew it. You did lose a lot of weight. I am no longer a fan of yours. You betrayed a lot of people. So I'll find another plus-size beautiful woman because you're full of –
You were full
grammar.
Of baloney.
You're full of shit. Hashtag damn shame. Hashtag just like the rest.
So
can you imagine the life of that person
entitled
who goes online is like you should have stayed fat or heavier or whatever.
Why the fuck do you care at all?
Yeah, like how does it affect you at all? In any way, shape, or form? That's you're betrayed?
Oh, man.
People are fucking nuts.
Even people like the – did you – and none of you guys saw the new Ghostbusters movie,
Oh,
right?
Yes, I did.
You saw
fucking
it.
Fucking opening night.
Really?
Yeah.
How was it?
I liked it.
Yeah?
It's better than the original.
Look at that straight face.
What, am I giggling? What are you guys laughing at? It's better than the original.
Because I've been with you on the set of Comic Book Men where every time it comes up, that's what you say.
Even they say
even
that
before
it's
it came
better
out.
Than the original.
Who's they? The
people that made the fucking
because
movie.
Because they can't. They want to show some respect – To the original, they can't come out and say it's better.
Okay, having not seen the movie, I will. How? In what ways is it a better movie?
It's a more it makes more sense, the plot lines.
How did the first one not make any sense?
There's a lot. It was a lot of like. It wasn't quite clear.
What wasn't clear?
Gozar. What was that thing? The
Gozarian?
Yeah, all that stuff. It was kind of long and it was kind of boring at parts. This one never stopped. I mean, from the moment the film opens till the minute it climaxes, it's giggle fest.
I have heard nothing but good reviews from people I know who have seen it. So I'm not arguing that it's a good movie. But you're not winning me over so far.
Why? How can I not win you over if I say it's better than the original?
And
I won't even talk about how much better it is in part two.
Well, I like part two.
Oh my God.
But I mean, you have to qualify it. You can't just say
it's
definitively it's better than the original.
It's hard to have an intelligent conversation with you if you like part two.
Part two is a very fun movie.
I'm out.
Well, what's wrong with part two?
Part two?
Because I love part two.
It was not fun.
It was so much fun.
I felt that the actors were going through the motions. They didn't really – they looked like they weren't having fun at all. They looked like they just – it was just like a paycheck for them.
Oh, I
probably. It wasn't a great villain for them.
Are you fucking kidding me? Viggo and Janosch?
Yeah.
They're fucking amazing. Janosch was brilliant. A way better villain.
You may be the minority on this one in terms. A lot of people didn't like Ghostbusters 2. You have to cop to that. That movie was not did not do it for the Ghostbusters.
I think
fandom.
That movie aged very well. Ghostbusters 2. I think it aged very very well actually.
Well, Q, what was your opinion on this female Ghostbusters?
Well, you didn't even see it. I'm surprised you didn't
see it.
Oh, you didn't see it. Oh, I thought you said you saw it and you liked it.
No, I didn't see it. I said a few people I know saw it and liked it. I didn't see it. I didn't see X-Men Apocalypse either. I just haven't had time to.
There is so many moments. If you love Ghostbusters, right?
Love it. It's my favorite movie.
Ghostbusters too. Of course he loves Ghostbusters.
But there are so many moments in this new film that you're going to be like, you're going to be grinning from ear to ear. You're going to look like a mental patient in the theater because there are so many nice touches and nice.
Like what?
Like they go to – they're looking for a headquarters. What yeah. I love too is that I really wasn't into it when I go walking in because I thought it was going to be that they were the 2016 version and that the original Ghostbusters were going to – they were going to acknowledge that in the 80s there was a Ghostbusters team.
And you don't like that better?
No, they didn't do that.
But why wouldn't you like that better? You don't like continuity and mythology and shit like that?
I don't – not in – I think a reboot was needed. Because you need to flush out all those memories of the original Ghostbusters. Just,
what?
You don't need it for this.
But they cast them in the movie.
Who cast who? Yes, I felt that was at all virtually done. The only reason I could see for that was out of respect because okay. They really didn't add anything to it. The original cast.
I see.
He's just like he's trying to get people to come after him. He's like, I haven't said anything outrageous.
I'm just letting him go. I'm just letting him go.
But no, you know when they're looking for a headquarters?
Yeah,
they go to the firehouse,
right?
And they get a quote on the rent there, and
they can't afford it.
They can't afford it. So then they go, and this makes much more sense. They go, and their headquarters is above a Chinese restaurant.
Well, how does that make more sense?
Because I mean, why would there be a firehouse for rent in New York City?
They're firehouse for sales. I mean, I haven't been.
Yeah, they
in
sell
a while.
Churches and stuff. Sure. Yeah, they sell.
When was the last time a firehouse went up on the block?
The one on Staten Island sold in the late 70s. For
okay, so the last
that's
time
when the first before the original one came out.
Yeah, but the Ghostbusters the first movie was made in 1980.
84.
No, the sequel came out in right
sequel,
in 84. Okay,
came out
so
in the 90s.
6 years later.
Or 89.
So or 6 years later, there wouldn't be a government building. For
I, well,
sure.
I
makes
mean.
Sense.
I just didn't – I felt that it would made more – it just felt more well, – that plus – but they go back to that though because they save the city and yeah. What and the city goes, what's that one thing we could do for you? Whatever you need, you name it. And they're like, we want this firehouse as our new
– oh, so in the end they get the firehouse? Okay, all right.
I thought the guy who played their secretary, he plays Thor.
Yes.
I don't want to say he steals the show because right. The girls were amazing. But he really – he really, really brings like, – he plays a dimwit. Which yeah. I think is nice because, you know, he plays with like the dimwit secretary. It's a nice take on some old
right.
Ideals.
Right. Okay.
And he does. And he's really funny. You wouldn't think that guy would be funny.
Who did you see it with?
Saw it with my wife.
Okay. And she liked it?
She thought it was fine. She didn't like the first Ghostbusters much either. So, and she felt that it was superior to the original as well.
I see. All right. Interesting.
Flanagans have stated their case.
Well, I haven't seen it, so I can't argue.
And the special effects?
Yep.
I mean, well, and I'm not saying this to be a jerk, but, you know, you obviously you're going to be able to do much more advanced stuff than you could do in the 80s.
Sure.
So the special effects just blow the
old. Oh, wow. Well, you're making me want to go see this.
Obliterate it.
You're making me want to go.
You should go. Slimer
so you can
reappears.
Come next week and be like, what the fuck were you talking about?
Slimer. You love Slimer? He's there.
Yeah, the only thing I don't like about that is I saw in a commercial there was a female Slimer
yes.
with wig and makeup yeah. on that looks so fucking corny.
It's – well, come on. It's
on the wrong side of corny.
But the you will like what they do with the female Slimer though. It's cute.
I mean it doesn't sound like my sensibilities, but a lot of people whose opinion I trust like the movie.
It's good.
All right.
Yeah, it's worth seeing.
Okay. Wow. Star yeah, Trek? Going to go see the new Star Trek?
No. Never was a fan of Star
Trek. Why? You don't like Gay Sulu?
Oh,
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 homophobe.
I wasn't even aware there was it was sexuality was brought into question.
Yeah, he sucks space cock.
Yeah. So
why? Why is that?
They show him and a his husband raising a kid.
But is he Sulu in this, or is he a new act, is he a new character?
He's Sulu and
same guy
and,
who played
what's
in
his
the
name
last
got mad. George
Takei.
Takei, yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. Okay, I thought you meant like the original Sulu made an appearance.
No. The new guy, John Cho, Harold and Kumar guy,
yeah.
In the third one is gay. They reveal that Sulu's gay.
I think it can only help, you know.
Sulu wasn't happy about it. He said that Roddenberry created these characters and there's no reason to change them for PC purposes.
I kind of agree with that. I don't mind that he's gay. It's fine, but it's like I do like the idea.
It seems
like
pandering.
Respect. And I just like the idea of respecting his thing. Like Roddenberry's vision, but I mean, these movies have so fucking gone off the rails with that anyway.
Did you like the new Star Trek reboots?
I do. I like them. They're more like straight up action films than like Star Trek films, but that's all right. That's all right. You still got the old films. I still have the original Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
Did it ruin your childhood?
Nah, it didn't ruin my childhood.
That's the thing that, like, you know, after the day after Ghostbusters opened?
Yeah.
Everything was fine, right? No, the world didn't end, and movies were still out there to watch, and there was no need to throw your little hissy fits,
right?
And stamp your feet and kick and scream and hold your breath because the Ghostbusters that you remembered is a bit different now.
Deal.
It's 2016.
Deal.
You're giving it two thumbs up.
Yeah.
Wow.
Two thumbs up, and the just I do believe though that there'll be moments where you're like, you know what, they did it.
There's no way. I'll tell you right now, it's going to be impossible for me to think that this is a better movie than the first.
Well, it did not do that great domestically, huh?
Oh, really? No.
Budget was 144. It made back 89.6 so far
in 2 weeks.
Yeah, that's they're donezo, man.
Yeah, they'll make another one.
No, they got to go. They've got to do another.
They'll make another one. They invested too much money into it to not make.
Oh no, I'm saying for this movie though, they won't make it back at least domestically.
Oh, and it won't play in China. That's a fucking big problem for them.
Why?
China has a law against the occult and in movies, and this falls under some sort of like.
Well,
I feel like the Stash is a Chinese province with all the shit he's fucking laying down to get him.
We're allowed to talk about the occult.
Yeah,
that's one thing.
It's almost mandatory.
Yeah, I go, the first thing he walks in, I'm like, "What do you got for me?"
Any satanic news?
Tell him, Steve, Dave.
This has been a production of Smodco Internet Radio. Sir, only at smodcast.com.